Discourse on Athanatia, Athanatia Sutta. Thus have I heard. On one occasion, the Blessed One was living on the Vulture's Peak near Rajagaha. Then, four great kings, having placed a guard over the four quarters, with a large army of Yakas, of Gandhabas, of Kumbandas, of Nagas, having placed troops, having placed a barricade of soldiers on four sides, came to the presence of the Blessed One. When the night was far advanced, illuminating the entire Vulture's Peak with their surpassing radiance, saluted the Blessed One and sat on one side. From among the attendant Yakas, some saluted the Blessed One and sat on one side. Some exchanged greetings with the Blessed One, conversing in a friendly and courteous manner, and sat on one side. Some saluted him with clasped hands and sat on one side. Some announced their name and lineage and sat on one side. Some sat on one side in silence. Then the great king Vesavana, who was seated on one side, said to the Blessed One, "Venerable Sir, Bhante, there are eminent Yakas who are not pleased with the Blessed One. There are also eminent Yakas pleased with the Blessed One. There are Yakas of middle rank who are not pleased with the Blessed One, and there are those who are pleased with the Blessed One. There are Yakas of inferior rank who are not pleased with the Blessed One, and there are those who are pleased with the Blessed One. The Yakas, Bhante, as a rule, are not pleased with the Blessed One. What is the reason for this?" "Well, the Blessed One teaches the Dhamma to establish abstention from killing, from stealing, from sexual misconduct, from false speech, and from liquor that causes intoxication and negligence. To them, such teaching is unpleasant and unpalatable." "Surely, Bhante, there are disciples of the Blessed One. They frequent the remote recesses of forest and woodland wilderness where there is no sound, no tumult, where breezes are void of human contact, and suitable for man's seclusion and quiet contemplation. There are eminent Yakas who haunt these forests, who have no faith in the word of the Blessed One." "Bhante, may the Blessed One learn the Atanatha protection so that the displeased Yakas may be pleased, so that the monks and nuns, laymen and laywomen, may be at ease, guarded, protected, and unharmed." The Blessed One gave consent by his silence. Then the great king Vesavana, knowing that the Blessed One had consented, recited the Atanatiya protection. "Homage to Vipassi, the Buddha, possessed of the eye of wisdom and splendor. Homage to Sikhi, the Buddha, compassionate towards all beings. Homage to Visabho, the Buddha, free from all defilements and possessed of ascetic energy. Homage to Kakusanda, the Buddha, the conqueror of the fivefold host of Mara. Homage to Konagamana, the Buddha, who has shed all defilements and had lived the holy life. Homage to Kassapa, the Buddha, who is fully freed from all defilements. Homage to Angirasa, the Buddha Gotama, the son of the Sakyas, who is full of radiance and who proclaimed the Dhamma that dispels all suffering. Those in the world who have extinguished the flames of passion and have perceived through insight things as they really are, they never slander anyone. They are mighty men who are free from fear. Gotama, the Buddha, dear to gods and men, endowed with knowledge and virtue, mighty and fearless, all do homage to him. Homage be to him. When the resplendent sun, offspring of Aditi, with its full orb, arises, then the night ceases, and it is called the day. The direction from which the sun arises is the east. There exists the ocean, deep and vast. This is a spreading sheet of water they know as the ocean. Where there is east, to the east of Mount Meru, they say that quarter is east. Custodian of this quarter is a great king named Dataratta, who has a retinue of attendants and is sovereign lord of the Gandhabas. Attended by Gandhabas, he enjoys their song and dance. Many are his Dataratta's sons, all of one name, so have I heard. 80 and 10 and 1 are they, Inda their name, and mighty are they. They too, beholding the Buddha, kinsman of the sun, mighty and fearless, salute him from afar. Homage to thee, who art unique among mankind. Glory to thee, the noblest among men. As by thy omniscience thou hast looked on mankind with a knowing eye, even the non-humans pay reverence to thee. This we have often heard. We therefore request the Yakas to pay homage to Gotama, the conqueror, the Buddha. They too say, we reverence Gotama, the conqueror. We reverence Gotama, who is endowed with knowledge and virtue. The direction from where the Petas, corpses, backbiters, murderers, the fierce brigands, and the deceitful are removed is the direction to the right of Mount Meru, and is called the quarter of the south. The custodian of this quarter is a great king named Virula, who has a retinue of attendants and is the sovereign lord of the Kumbandas. Attended by the Kumbandas, he enjoys their song and dance. Many are his Virula's sons, all of one name, so have I heard. 80 and 10 and 1 are they, Inda their names, and mighty are they. They too, beholding the Buddha, kinsman of the sun, mighty and fearless, salute him from afar. Homage to thee, who art unique among mankind. Glory to thee, the highest among men. As by thy omniscience thou hast looked on mankind with a knowing eye, even the non-humans pay reverence to thee. This we have often heard. We therefore request the Yakas to pay homage to Gotama, the conqueror, the Buddha. They too say, we reverence Gotama, the conqueror. We reverence Gotama, who is endowed with knowledge and virtue. When the resplendent sun, offspring of Aditi, with his full orb, sets, then the day ceases, and it is called night. The direction where the sun sets is the west. There exists the ocean, deep and vast. This, a spreading sheet of water, they know as the ocean. Where there is west, to the west of Mount Meru, they say that quarter is west. Custodians of this quarter is a great king named Virupaka, who has a retinue of attendants, and is sovereign lord of the Nagas. Attended by Nagas, he enjoys their song and dance. Many are his Virupaka's sons, all of one name, so have I heard. 80 and 10 and 1 are they, Inda their name, and mighty are they. They too, beholding the Buddha, kinsman of the sun, mighty and fearless, salute him from afar. Homage to thee, who art unique among men. Glory to thee, the noblest among men. As by thy omniscience thou hast looked on mankind with a knowing eye, even the non-humans pay reverence to thee. This we have often heard. We therefore request the Yakas to pay homage to Gotama, the conqueror, the Buddha. They too say, we reverence Gotama, the conqueror. We reverence Gotama, who is endowed with knowledge and virtue. Where lies delightful Uttarakuru, the northern continent, where towers beautiful Mount Meru, there are born men who are selfless and unattached. They neither sow the seed nor use the plow. Spontaneously grown corn is there for them to enjoy. The rice, purged of the red powder and of husk, clean and sweet-scented, is boiled in golden vessels. It is this that they partake of. They make of cows a single-seated mount, like mounting on horseback, and ride about from place to place. They make use of women and men, girls and boys, as vehicles, and travel from place to place in them. Mounting on vehicles, on elephants and horses, they, the Yakas of King Vesavana, travel in every direction. This king, who has a retinue of attendants, is possessed of elephants and horses on which he rides. He also has celestial chariots, palaces, and palanquins. He has cities well built in the celestial regions. Their names are Atanata, Kusinata, Parakusinata, Natapurya, Parakusitanata. To the north, the city of Kapilavata. To the south, Janoga. The cities named Navanavati, Ambara Ambaravati, and the kingdom of Alakamanda. Happy one, this Kuvera, another name for Vesavana, has a kingdom named Vishna. Therefore, the great king Kuvera is called Vesavana. There are Yakas of this king who hold investigations and make them known. They are Tatola, Tatala, Tatotala, Ojasi, Tejasi, Tatojasi, Suro, Raja, Suraraja, Arito, Nemi, Arita Nemi. There, in Visana kingdom, lies the lake Dharani, whence rain clouds, drawing water, pour them forth. And there is also the hall named Bhagalavati, where the Yakas assemble. There, round about the hall, are trees bearing perpetual fruit. On these trees there are multitudes of birds. There also is heard the cry of peacocks and herons, and the melodious song of coquillas, the Indian cuckoo. There, near the lake, the cry of the birds, who call, "Live ye, live ye, jivam jivaka," is heard. The bird Ottavachitaka, "Oh, lift your hearts," the jungle fowl, the crabs, and the Pokarasataka birds roam the woods. There, the cry of the parrot, the minor birds, and the Dandamanavaka birds is heard. And Kuvera's lotus lake ever lies in her beauty in all season. That direction, to the north of Mount Meru, is called by people the quarter of the north. The custodian of this quarter is a great king named Kuvera, who has a retinue of attendants, and is sovereign lord of the Yakas. Attended by the Yakas, he enjoys their songs and dance. Many are his Kuvera's sons, all of one name, so have I heard. 80 and 10 and 1 are they, Inda their names, and mighty are they. They too, beholding the Buddha, kinsman of the sun, mighty and fearless, salute him from afar. Homage to thee, who are unique among mankind. Glory to thee, the noblest among men. As by thy pure omniscience thou hast looked on mankind, even the non-humans pay reverence to thee. This we have heard. We therefore request the Yakas to pay homage to Gotama, the conqueror, the Buddha. They too say, "We reverence Gotama, the conqueror. We reverence Gotama, who is endowed with knowledge and virtue." Happy one, this is the Atanata protection, whereby both the monks and nuns, laymen and laywomen, may live at ease, guarded, protected, and unharmed. If any monk or nun, layman or laywoman, learns by heart this Atanatha protection, and be word perfect in repeating it, and if any non-human male or female yaka, youth or maiden yaka, yaka minister or any yaka or yaka attendant, male or female Gandhaba, male or female Kumbanda, male or female Naga, were to walk with him or her, or stand or sit or lie down with him or her with malevolent intent, such a non-human, happy one, will not obtain hospitality from any town or township, will not obtain a place to dwell, nor could live in the kingdom of Alakamanda. He will not be able to attend the meetings of the yakas. Further, he would not be accepted or given in marriage. He would be reproached by casting remarks on his deformed teeth or eyes or any part of the body, and the non-human would put an empty bowl over his head and split it in 7 pieces. Happy one! There are non-humans who are fierce, violent, given to retaliation. Those non-humans heed neither the four great kings, nor their ministers, nor their attendants. They are called rebels against the four great kings. Even as in the kingdom of Magadha, the thieves heed neither the king of Magadha, nor the ministers, nor their attendants, and are called rebels against the king of Magadha. So there are non-humans who are fierce. They are called rebels against the four great kings. Happy one! If any non-human, male or female yaka, youth or maiden yaka, yaka minister or any yaka, or yaka attendant, male or female Gandhaba, male or female Kumbanda, male or female Naga, were to walk with a monk or nun, or a layman or laywoman, or stand or sit or lie down with him or her with malevolent intent, they should, the molested one, inform, cry aloud, and shout to those yakas, to the mighty yakas, their commanders and chief commanders, saying, "This yaka is seizing me, takes possession of me, is harassing me, assailing me, is harming me intensely and would not let me go." Who are the yakas, mighty yakas and commanders, the chief commanders, to whom such appeal should be made? Inda, Soma and Varuna, Bharadvaja, Ajapati, Kandana, Kamasetta II, Kinugandu, Nigahandu, Panada, Opamana II, Devasata and Matali, Chittasena and Gandhaba, Nala, Raja, Janasabha, Satagira, Hemavata, Punaka, Karatiya, Gula, Sivaka, Mukalinda II, Vesamitta, Yugandhara, Gopala, Supageda II, Hiri, Neti, and Mandiya, Panchalakanda, Alavaka, Pajuna, Sumana, Sumuka, Dadamuka, with these Sarisaka. These are the yakas, mighty yakas, the commanders, the chief commanders, to whom the molested one should inform, cry aloud, and shout, saying, "This yaka is seizing me, takes possession of me, is harassing me, assailing me, is harming me, and harming me intensely, and this yaka would not let me go." This, happy one, is the Atanatha protection whereby monks and nuns, laymen and laywomen, may live at ease, guarded, protected, and unharmed. Happy one, we now take our leave of you, for we have many duties to attend to. So said the four great kings. "Great kings, it is time for your departure," replied the Buddha. The four great kings arose from their seats and saluted the Blessed One, circled around him to his right side, and there and then vanished. From among the attendant yakas, some rose from their seats and saluted the Blessed One, circled round him on his right side, and there and then vanished. Some exchanged greetings with the Blessed One, conversing in a friendly and courteous manner, and there and then vanished. Some saluted the Blessed One with clasped hands, and there and then vanished. Some announced their name and lineage, and there and then vanished. Some, in silence, there and then vanished. When the night had passed, the Blessed One addressed the monks. The Buddha related to the monks, word for word, what has been said by the great king Vasavana. Learn by heart, monks, the Atanatha protection. Constantly make use of it. Bear it in mind. This Atanatha protection, monks, pertains to your welfare, and by virtue of it, monks and nuns, laymen and laywomen, may live at ease, guarded, protected, and unharmed. This the Blessed One said. Those monks, glad at heart, rejoiced at the words of the Blessed One.